5 years ago, I stood in this exact same position and I did a comparison video between the DJI Inspire 2 and at that time, the Mavic Air, which was the smallest, most affordable drone that DJI made. We have come a long way in 5 years, and today I am back in this spot because I figured this would be a great place to compare what I think are the two most popular drones that DJI now makes, and it is the DJI Mini 4 Pro and the DJI Mavic 3 Pro. Both of these are incredible drones, and my goodness, the quality has gotten so good in these little things, but today I'm going to tell you which one I think is actually the better drone for you, and which drone you should consider if you're thinking about buying a new DJI drone. Hey, sorry to quickly interrupt this video, but I wanted to tell you that whether you're choosing the Mini 4 Pro or the Mavic 3 Pro, I would highly recommend that you buy it from my good friends over at Cardinal Camera. I know there are a lot of options when it comes to where you purchase your gear, but the great thing about Cardinal Camera is that you can get everything tax-free, which really saves you hundreds of dollars, especially if you're considering any of these drones. I really like supporting a local business, but also a business that can save you money as well, is I think a great perk. So I've talked about them before. I buy all my stuff there. And if you could click the link, it'll get to you just as fast as Amazon and B&H and all those companies anyway, and you'll save money on tax-free purchases. Click the link below, show your support, save some money. It's a win-win for everybody. In this video, I'm going to talk a little bit about why I think the DJI Mini 4 Pro is actually the best drone for most people when it comes to affordability, size, and quality. And I'll also talk to you about why I think the Mavic 3 Pro actually might make more sense for you if you're a serious cinematographer looking to take your drone stuff to the next level, or if you do this for a living. So let's first talk about some of the similarities between these drones. Range and battery life are something that I think are extremely important when it comes to making the decision on which drone is best for you, because the longer the battery life, the longer that you can have the drone in the air and get the shots you want without having to come down and recharge, and also without having to buy a lot of batteries. Even though I always recommend having a lot of extra batteries for drones so that you never have to worry about running out, both of these have almost identical battery life. It's about 45 minutes when you're actually using them, which is incredible. Years ago, it was impressive when you were able to get battery life that lasted 20 some minutes in the air. And now the fact that both of these get almost 45 minutes is awesome. The amount of times that I'm up getting time lapses or I'm flying around and just not having to worry about battery life is tremendous. So they both get about 45 minutes of battery life, obviously a little bit less depending on the wind and depending on how fast you're flying, but overall battery life is pretty identical. In terms of range, usually the bigger the drone, the further the range because the antennas are bigger and the transmission is stronger, but honestly the Mini 4 Pro has as far, if not further range than the actual Mavic 3 Pro, which is crazy. The good news when it comes to range is just simply that the further the range you have, the more reliable it is for actual real life use when you're flying within a mile of yourself, let's just say. Both have great range, both have great battery life. Let's talk a little bit about the controller. So this right here is the DJI RC, which actually came out before the new DJI RC 2. So what's interesting about that is this is actually a newer and more powerful remote control that comes with the less expensive drone when you buy it with the kit. But they do actually make an updated, better version of this called the RC Pro that is designed more for the Mavic 3 Pro. But in typical DJI fashion, you can't use the DJI RC 2 with the Mavic 3 Pro. You can only use the new RC. It's confusing and annoying, but this is the one for the DJI Mini 4, and this is the Mavic 3 Pro. Internal antennas only, internal antennas and two external antennas on the RC. Both have about the same size screen, about the same brightness. The DJI RC Pro for the Mavic 3 Pro does get a little bit brighter, but overall about the exact same type of controllers. I do love having the screens internal. I highly recommend if you get drones, you get the ones with internal screens because it's so much better than having to connect your phone and get out the phone and connect things, and it's a hassle. This is a great way. You just pop them out, turn them on, and you're ready to roll. But really what you probably care about is how much better does the Mavic 3 Pro at about $2,200 for the drone look compared to the Mini 4 Pro at about $750? Let's fly these things. All right, so first up, let's take a look here at the Mini 4 Pro. Now, one thing to note about the Mini 4 Pro is the highest quality you can get from the camera is 4K 60 frames a second, which is awesome. You can get 4K 120 frames a second and actually 5.7K on the Mavic 3 Pro, but for most people that might not be a big deal. One big advantage of size when it comes to the Mini 4 Pro is the fact that because it's so small, you can kind of bring it with you everywhere. You can keep it in a camera case and it's nice and small and you can just pop it out when you want to use it. Where the bigger the drone, the less likely you are to have it with you at all times. And that can play a big factor if you're someone that just kind of spontaneously decides, oh, this would be a great drone shot. I love the fact that I can keep the Mini 4 with me everywhere and know that I don't have to sacrifice quality just because it's convenient that it's with me. The Mini 4 Pro is the first Mini that I've actually used that actually has extremely good video quality at such a tiny size. So you can see right now, I'm at about 4 bars going down to 3 bars of remote control connection here, and then it goes up to 5 bars and it goes back and forth. Obviously that's pretty common, but I'm only 2,000 feet away, so not even a half mile away, and getting a little bit of interference, which naturally happens. This is a very urban setting with lots of things that can, you know, obviously get in the way from an interference perspective. We also have some tall trees next to me here. So overall, it's kind of what you expect, and why I say that you should never look at something like a 12 mile range and think that that's actually going to be realistic, because honestly, it's just not going to be. But I can say from experience that most of the drone flying that I do is, you know, a half mile or a mile away. And usually it's line of sight, because that's the way that you should fly safely anyway. So the range is not a huge deal from that perspective, but it is something to keep in mind. So you can see I just got an interference notification at about 3,500 feet. It says weak signal and adjust antennas. Obviously can't adjust the antennas anymore, so it's just obviously losing interference a little bit. Now I will say I am not using ND filters on the Mini 4 Pro. I do not own them for the Mini 4 Pro. They do not come with the Fly More kit like the Mavic 3 Pro does. You can get ND filters for this, and yes, that does make a little bit of a difference. I am at a pretty high shutter speed right now of 2500, but when it comes to the little drone like this, I really don't worry too much about cranking the shutter, because for what I'm trying to get, it's usually not that big of a deal. But keep that in mind, because the Mavic 3 Pro does come with the ND filters and the Fly More kit, and I do have those on because they are in the kit. One important thing to note about size when it comes to the Mini 4 Pro is that it is under 249 grams. If you don't know what 249 grams means and what the significance of that is, this drone is small enough that you do not actually have to have a Part 107 to fly it recreationally. That's a very important thing, because if you are someone that just wants a drone that you can be able to use and get some great shots with just for your own use, it's nice that you don't have to have the Part 107 for this specific drone. That's what that 249 grams means. Now let's take a look at the Mavic 3 Pro. So one of the biggest differences, obviously, right away that you notice with this drone, not just when you're looking at the footage, but at the drone in general, is that 3-camera system with the Hasselblad lenses. That's obviously a big pro when it comes to quality, not just the actual image quality itself, which obviously does look significantly better. You also get a much better dynamic range with those sensors, which is very important when you're trying to capture highlights as well as shadows. You also will get better color profile, but even more so, you get 3 lenses. You have a 24 millimeter all the way up to, I believe it's 162 millimeter. I'll flash them on the screen right now, but that's actually pretty nice to have. It's not just so that you can get in further to be able to obviously see something closer. That's obviously one perk. But there's also something called lens compression, which you're not used to really seeing on drones, and you can get some really unique perspectives on what you're shooting. So yes, it is nice being able to get closer to a subject from further away, but also you get a different look, and I'll explain that in a second. So when I talk about lens compression and what a different shot you can get, here's a good way to show it to you right here. So you can see that this shot basically is what I kind of had with the Mini 4 Pro. And obviously I could get closer with the drone if I chose, but the difference of what happens if I hit here to the 3x telephoto, you can see obviously how much closer I get to it, but also how different that shot looks, how that compression will bring that background a little bit closer to this subject. And then I could take it another step further and I could switch here to the 7x telephoto and look how different that shot is. Now, obviously the shot itself is different from that lens compression, but also look how close and detailed I can get to that. So if you are using this for inspections of some sort with buildings or trying to get shots where you want to get some really close up shots, but you can't fly the drone so close, you can see how much of a difference that 7x goes in comparison to that 1x. So that could be a really important thing for people that are using this drone for a lot of other uses, because if you see here as I go back to 1x, that's just how far away I am from that those stacks there. And the fact that I can get that close and see the kind of detail of the ladders and the stuff that's happening in that is pretty awesome. If you're unsure about lens compression, there are lots of really, really good videos on YouTube, especially from Full-Time Filmmaker. They did one that showed all the comparisons of them, and you can see what a difference lens compression actually makes. Learn more about that, because it's actually very important when you're deciding what lens actually makes sense for you in general, whether it's photography or video. So here's the same shot I was basically getting with the other drone as well from this angle. This is all the 1x. And once again, if I were to stop this and I were to go ahead and hit that 7x zoom, I mean, look at the difference in terms of what I can get detail wise from far away, which is obviously really, really cool. I specifically can see that super dirty building that needs to be pressure washed. Now, one thing they did that's cool is when you are in that 7x or 3x, they purposely made it so when you are turning the drone, it actually turns way slower because you're so zoomed in. You could obviously see movement so much more. So even when you're turning what feels like fast, if you actually look at the drone, it's not moving very fast. And so it allows you to get a more stable shot. So overall, what is the best drone for you? I think the answer is pretty simple. If you are looking to do cinematography or photography professionally, and you want to have a very high quality drone with those three lenses that really lets you get a lot closer to the subject, gets a different look, has a little bit better dynamic range, a little bit higher codec, all that, the Mavic 3 Pro, of course, is going to be the better drone for you because it is a little bit more of a professional drone. That's why it's about 3 times the price. It's also a drone that when you pull out with a client and you're using with a client, it's obviously going to look a little bit more professional. The Mini 4 Pro is such a tiny drone, and it's the one that most people see when they go into a local store like Best Buy or something where they're obviously looking at drones. So being able to have a drone that maybe they haven't seen before that looks more professional with those lenses could be a big deal if you are someone that does a lot of client work. Doesn't mean that you have to get that drone though. I think for most people, the Mini 4 Pro is probably the best drone for you because of the fact that it's under 249 grams, so you don't need to have a Part 107. It allows you to get just as much range, just as much battery life. You can bring it with you anywhere, so it's super portable, easy to use, and always have with you. And for most people, that's probably gonna be the most important thing. You're still gonna get outstanding quality with that little drone, and you will not be disappointed with that. I've really, really liked it, and honestly, I have that with me more than any other drone. And even though I usually will always choose the Mavic 3 Pro or the Inspire 2 when I'm doing professional work, I absolutely have used the Mini 4 Pro for professional work before when that was the only drone I had with me. And clients never know the difference, honestly. It really is just a fantastic drone and the quality is just outstanding. So overall, the choice is yours. I hope this video was somewhat helpful just to see a comparison. How much better is a drone that's about 3 times the cost? I think it really comes down to what features you're looking for and what you're planning on doing with it. So, as always, thanks for watching. If you're new to this channel and you've never subscribed, please do. I like doing more reviews like this, and I'd love to know kind of what you think. Which drone is right for you? Comment below. Thanks.